I'm Alberto Rios. You're watching Books and Company, and we're joined today by best-selling author Ian Rankin, who's talking about his new John Rebus book, Standing in Another Man's Grave. 18th John Rebus book. Will there be more?
Oh, that's a cruel question.
It's a terrible question, I know.
It's very bad luck for me to say
okay,
what I'm doing
next. Fair enough. I like the way you were talking as we were going through the program, though, about this being a big puzzle. And we're putting something together,
Well, the crime novel is that anyway, right?
Fair enough.
There's a kind of construct there, which is why it hasn't always been taken seriously as literature. Yeah. Because A, it's a closed universe. It seems like a closed universe. At the end of the book, all your questions have been answered to your satisfaction as a reader, and there seems to be no life outside of it. I like to leave a few loose ends trailing, because real life is messy.
Okay.
But crime fiction brings to the reader a satisfaction of all their questions being answered. Mm-hmm. But I think that's why it's not been taken seriously as literature sometimes. Yeah,
readers are coming to it.
Well, right? They are. Yeah. I mean, this notion that within this very, very staid construct of crime, investigation, resolution, mm-hmm. beginning, middle, and end, mm-hmm. you can do anything you want. Mm-hmm. Within that, you can do anything you want. And I think that's really refreshing.
You're describing prosody as well. In formal poem, you know, you've got so many lines, so many stanzas, whatever, and you can accomplish within that.
And you have, your detective is an archetypal character. I mean, some people confuse archetype with stereotype.
Right.
You know, I mean, most of them are loners. Right. Most of them have got, you know, problems. They've got busted marriages. They maybe drink too much. They're not social animals, et cetera, et cetera. So Rebus is definitely part of that tradition. Mm-hmm. He's part of the kind of Philip Marlowe, you know, sort of private eye, who has his own set of rules, but they're not necessarily the same rules as the police would use.
Mm-hmm. And yet it's a code of honor.
Right? It is.
It's no less than what they're... Yeah. What they're.
And with Rebus, the reason he's a cop and the reason he's a good detective is the same reason as a bad social human being. He's completely... focused on the job, he's obsessive, because mm-hmm. if he's looking at other people's lives and other people's problems, he doesn't have to investigate himself too closely. He doesn't have to look at his own self and his own problems too closely.
Okay, well, and we don't want to jump to any, you know, psychobabble here, but all the drinking, all the, you know, it is hard to know where that fits in. But
well, writing is therapy.
Okay.
And I mean, often I say to other crime writers, we would, you know, what would we be like if we didn't get all this dark stuff down on the page? Because it keeps us very well balanced, I think. Mm. And, you know, various issues in my personal life, I've been able to deal with them by just giving them to Rebus. Mm. And it's a way of, it's like an exorcism. Mm. It's getting all those demons out.
Okay, I like that.
Yeah.
And it's not just Rebus. You've done so many things. You get to put all that stuff out there in the many different people that you've been.
Mm-hmm.